Hi Maastricht, my name is Pieter Jan de Graaf, and as you can see, I'm not sitting next to my usual co-host today, but next to...
Frida Farici, aka Mafi G.
And welcome to yet another episode of Breaking Mass. What's coming up next in our show? Well, we have an interesting interview with Dick Valentine, the lead singer of Electric Six. We have a Sinterklaas report, which you actually did.
Yeah. And last but not least, we have a report on the 1920s themed Winter Ball. Stay tuned.
Better students pay higher tuition fees. You might remember from the past that the top 3% of best performing students here got their tuition fees back at the end of the year. However, national government has different ideas.
Yes, Peter, actually, they're contemplating something completely the opposite. Instead of rewarding their students for all their hard work, they're actually thinking of charging double the school fees for this excellence program. However, Maastricht University is quite against this notion, specifically honor program coordinator Rob de Vries.
Yeah, he quoted, "We cultivate an elite by giving better opportunities to people with more money." Well, this is a very interesting subject, and let's see how it turns out for the student here in Maastricht. We're gonna get entrepreneurial again.
Yes, ladies, brace yourselves because our handsome reporter Alex did a report on the Global Entrepreneurship Week.
And it's organized by Eva. Let's have a look at the report.
Today, all around the world, entrepreneurs are meeting. Also in Maastricht, it is the Global Entrepreneurship Week, which has been organized by the Center for Entrepreneurship in Maastricht. Students, but also entrepreneurs, are able to meet to listen to the panel discussions, speeches, and also exchange ideas. Let's have a look how the entrepreneurial spirit is doing. Anna, how's it been today?
Hi, it's been unbelievable. We've been working so hard to put this together and to see everything happening and welcome everybody and seeing all of the speakers. It's such a great experience. Our aim is to encourage more students to start as an entrepreneur. So we want to have more entrepreneurs in the region. What do they need? What kind of support? Do they know about entrepreneurship? Do they know that they can actually start while they're doing their studies? So this is what we focus on. And we have a lot of very different events. So we do networking drinks and work sessions and all sorts of things. But we have two big ones in the year. We have the Global Week in November and then the Master Week of Entrepreneurship in May.
We design, develop and improve all kinds of digital applications. It can be an e-commerce site for a telco or games, serious games. And we're in Belgium, we're one of the top players. So I'm an entrepreneur. I speak from first-hand experience. If I had to pinpoint something within entrepreneurs, then it's the fact of that they're not afraid to fail. And learn from it, of course.
And what are you going to take from this event today? What are you going to take back home?
Also inspiration, as Elena said. It's just the vibe which you can get. I think if you're an employee in a company, it's like day-to-day routine. And here you can think outside the box and take something back home and think about what you can create yourself.
So many good ideas. So many entrepreneurs. I have no idea what I should do as a business plan. I just have you, me and the biscuits. Hang on, that's an idea. I'm gonna make a biscuit app where you can find all the free biscuits in Maastricht. Everybody loves biscuits, hello? Yes, finally, I'm an entrepreneur.
I'm sure Alex is gonna make a lot of dough.
Cookie dough?
Cookie dough.
Anyway, coming up next, we have an interview with Dick from Electric Six, which was actually done by Pieter Jan over here, and an expert of Electric Six, Fred.
Fred, let's have a look.
I'm standing in front of the Muziekgieterij. There's a long queue behind me. We have an interview with Dick Valentine, the lead singer of the band Electric Six. You might know them from, well, their really famous song, Gay Bar or Danger High Voltage. Let's go inside, shall we? We're inside the Muziekgieterij right now. I'm standing here next to Dick Valentine and Fred. Fred will be helping me out with the interview because she's quite the expert when it comes down to Electric Six. We should go ahead and ask some questions.
Yes. So, Mr. Dick Valentine, may I call you Dick?
Yeah, you can call me whatever you like. Just don't,
Dick.
Just don't call me late for dinner.
Okay. So Dick, tell me, who are the men, who are the real Electric Six? Who are the men behind the Dick?
I like that a lot. It's a great bunch of guys, really. You can't play as many shows as we do without really great guys. It's just a great group of guys. We love touring. We love making money. The money allows us to tour. The money is why we go and tour. We hang around each other to make more money for each other and for ourselves.
So, well, I have another question, because the band's lineup changes, well, in my opinion, almost constantly.
Sure.
So why is that exactly? Is it like differences in the band, or is it just, I don't know?
Well, there's the real answer, and then there's the real answer is more complicated, I think. So the short answer is, I'm an asshole.
And what do you think of this beautiful venue?
Well, this venue is, I think, it's a great repurposed building. You take an infrastructure like this. It was clearly made for child labor, or you have sweatshops kind of everywhere you go. Get rid of the sweatshops, export them to Bangladesh, open up a music venue here, and also bring in a team of Dutch graphic designers, guys who look like they're villains from Die Hard. Give them some cubicles to work with, design some shit, and you've got a complex here for the next generation of Dutch people, and Belgians as well. So thanks a lot.
Well, that looked like a really cool venue, but what more can we expect from this Breaking Moss episode of Party Report on the Winter Ball?
Yeah, well, coming up next actually is your report on Sinterklaas, a Dutch cultural phenomenon, but what is it exactly about? Well, just let's have a look.
Let it bump, though.
Steamboat all the way from the Spanish. Something, something, something looking all tannish. Sinterklaas my name, reppin' is my game. Sorry Santa Claus, better put your swag on pause. All the kiddies love me, I put candies in their shawls. Yeah, so boys and girls, little and big, hope you all been good this year. You dig?
It may be a cold day here in Maastricht, but not at the Maas Boulevard, where there are happy faces all around. Children and their parents are anticipating the arrival of Sinterklaas here in Maastricht, and Breaking Maas is integrating with the locals so that we can get a better idea of this Dutch culture. Hello, ben jij Sinterklaas?
Nee.
Wie is Sinterklaas?
Een man.
De beste kindervriend.
En wie had die bij zich allemaal?
Pieter.
En wat hebben die Pieten in hun zakken?
Snoepjes.
As a parent, what does this Dutch tradition mean to you?
It's very important because our children, we want our children to have the same dreams of this party as we had as a child. And as I told you, my biggest traumatism of my youth was the day I discovered that Sinterklaas is not existing.
Do you think your children have been good this year? Will they get all their presents from Sinterklaas?
Sometimes they're good. Sometimes we can say, well, you have to listen to us because Sinterklaas is coming.
Of course.
But always it's they're very exciting when it's the 5th of December, and they with all the before they make their wish list, and it's nice.
Okay.
It's also for the parents.
Maybe this year you'll have long wish lists.
Yeah. They have every time they have a long wish list. So
now I will heel graag wil ik een baby pop.
Xbox. Ook een Xbox.
Ik wil een babypadje.
Een rockgitaar.
I think now we know a little bit more about this Dutch tradition. I think we're gonna enjoy the festivities a little bit. Peter, I want a baby bath as well.
A baby bath and an Xbox would be great, actually. But we have something coming up, namely our last report, the Winter Ball.
But first, let's check out what's happening in Maastricht during the next 2 weeks.
Where will you be on the night of the 3rd of December? Well, Double Trouble has a party coming up, and this time they have a night permit, so party till 5.
How about growing your own burger? Mark Post, Professor Mark Post, knows all about it. On the 6th of December, move your beef to the MBB and check it out.
And who doesn't love drinking for a good cause? La Foundation is throwing a benefit party for their first year anniversary on the 6th of December. All proceeds go to India. Bitches love me, my bitches love me, my bitches love me. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. I could give a fuck by no hate as long as my bitches love me. My bitches love me, my bitches love me. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. I could give a fuck by no nigga as long as these bitches love me. Pussy ass nigga, stop hating. Little tone chick got that fire. And he's always.
Yo, man, you going to the Winter Ball tonight?
You got tickets left?
This is my last one, man.
You gonna sell it?
Yeah, how much you got?
Well, let's see.
Hang on. We're from Breaking Mars. We can do a report on the Winter Ball.
You're damn sure you
So we managed to do a report on the Scope Winter Ball today. We're at the Hotel L'Imperial now. Seems a bit empty at the foyer, but let's see how the 20s are going with Paul. Paul, have you found any interviewees?
Thank you, Alex. So let's see how the people enjoy the party. So are you enjoying the 20s tonight?
Yeah, I do. It's amazing. Oh, it's so good. Great.
That all the people in here are properly dressed for the 20s.
Yeah, I think everybody is dressed amazingly, really like the 1920s, just like you.
Did you come here because you like the motto Great Gatsby or the 20s?
Yeah, we really like the motto Great Gatsby, and we really like the fashion of the 20s, so we really like this festival. We should be here more.
How are the 20s doing for you?
Probably like the Great Gatsby.
All right. And what makes you look 20s tonight?
I got curly hair and a long black dress.
So I have another reporter standing up here, and let's see what he says.
So tell me, how much are you in the 20s?
I'm so much into the 20s, I even got a mustache.
Here with Robert, one of the main organizers of tonight's event. Tell us about how did you come from last year's masquerade to this year's 20s?
Well, this year in the cinemas they showed the Great Gatsby, and we thought that people really like to dress up smartly, and as well with the hotel. It's a really nice location, so we thought we should use this theme, and we chose it, and it's working out really well.
Well, we've just been at a fabulous party in the 1920s, and Paul?
Now we're looking forward to the 1930s, or do we?
To be honest, seriously, 2013 is very good. I don't need the 30s, I just need 2013, new technology, Apple, all that kind of shit, it's awesome.
On our today's episode of Back to Social, we're gonna play another game, which is called
Trading Game. Trading Game.
Right. And what we are doing is we have this flag.
Just a little Dutch flag.
Yeah, we talk to people on the street and try to convince them to change it for something better.
Is it
really tasty?
It's really tasty.
Really, really tasty.
Chocolate.
And you can study, you can learn, you can
something good out of it. True. Let's just go for a beer, there's a bar.
Yeah, let's skip trading. Or we take this pen and try to trade it for a beer. Or even better, two beer.
Ah, come on man, this idea will never work.